हेलो फ्रेंड्स, माई सेल्फ प्रोफेसर संजय पुरोहित। आई वुड लाइक टू एक्सटेंड ए वार्म वेलकम टू यू ऑन माई यूट्यूब चैनल। आई वुड लाइक टू थैंक्स एवरी वन हु हैज सब्सक्राइब्ड माई चैनल एंड एनकरेज यू टू डू सो इफ यू हैव नॉट ऑलरेडी सब्सक्राइब्ड इट। प्लीज सब्सक्राइब इट so that you will get a new video notification earliest. Friends, today we are going to talk about fracture. In the orthopedic series, this is my first lecture. Fracture, basic concept and classification. Fracture. Breach in continuity of heart tissue like bone and cartilage with and without displacement of fragments. Fracture is also known as bone broken, bone break, bone crack, but these are not an orthopedic term. Fractures are abbreviated as FRX, FX, or by this symbol. Fractures are associated with soft tissue damage of varying degree. Type of fracture and degree of soft tissue damage depend upon cause of fracture, bone involved, site of fracture, temperament of the animal, time lapse between the infliction of injury and treatment given. Predisposing factors: congenital conformational deformities, old age, smooth and slippery ground surface as urbanization take place, the animals shifted into pakka houses, shed or the stables under the urine and dungs, the floor is slippery, that on that there is more chance of the fracture. Pregnancy, lactation lead to decrease the calcium in the animal's body and bone become weak, that cause the predispose for the fracture. Metabolic or pathological problems, concurrent musculoskeletal problems leading to uneven distribution of the weight. Etiology. Now we discuss about the etiology. Fractures are caused by the two causes, extensive causes and intrinsic causes. Extensive causes are present outside the animal's body. These are present outside the animal's body. These are the causes which are present outside the body, while the intrinsic causes are present inside the animal's body. So we first discuss about the extrinsic causes. That these causes present outside the body means environmental causes, in which the extrinsic causes are two types: direct trauma or indirect trauma. First we discuss about the direct trauma. Direct trauma is the most common cause of the fracture in the animals as well as in the human beings. These direct trauma are commonly by the automobile accidents, fighting, direct hit, etc. Under the direct trauma, There may be comminuted or multiple fractures occurs. Indirect trauma. Forces following a trauma is transmitted to weak point within the bone and fracture may occurs. This type of the indirect trauma occurs during the running, jumping or falling. Under the indirect trauma, first is the bending forces. When bending forces applied to a bone causes a break in the cortex of the opposite side, this side. Sudden stepping into a hole or on a lower level while running is caused the bending forces. Under the influence of these bending forces, there may be oblique or transverse fractures of the bone occurs. Now we discuss about the torsional forces. When a bone is twisted along its own axis, that is, one end is fixed and other end made to rotate, twisting of the limbs. In these directions, the fracture types under these torsional forces is spiral, that may be the short spiral or long spiral fracture. Compressive forces. One end of the bone is fixed position and other is forced toward it. Under the influence of the compressive forces, there may be compression fracture or compacted fractures. Compressive forces, when one end is fixed and other end is forced toward it. Shearing forces. Force is transmitted along the axis of the bone to the peripheral portion of the bone, same bone, tearing that portion off. Fracture line is parallel to the direction of the applied forces. This is the direction of the applied forces, and then this is the direction of the fracture line. Occurs in the bony prominence and outgrowing structures. Tension forces. Force that pull apart both the axial and axial ends like this. This direction and in this direction. One end of the bone must be in the fixed position while the other end is forced away from the fixed end. Second one is the intrinsic cause. These cause or the factors are present inside the animal's body. The intrinsic causes are divided into two major categories: muscular contractions and pathological fractures. So first we discuss about the muscular contractions. Violent contractions of the skeletal muscle cause the bone fragment to chip off from the point of attachment. This type of the fractures are very common at the acumen process, greater humeral tubercle, polyconal process, ischial tuberosity, trochanter major, cranial tibial fibrosity, calcaneus of the fibular tarsal bone. Now we discuss about the pathological fractures. Local or systemic pathological conditions render the bone too weak. Fractures may occur under the weight of animal itself. These pathological conditions of the bone may be osteosarcoma, osteomyelitis, osteoporosis, rickets, cyst, or other type of the bone infections and diseases. This is the ट्यूमर ऑफ दी बोन अंडर दिस दी रेडोग्राफी ऑफ दी फ्रैक्चर्स ऑफ द बोन बाय दी पैथोलॉजिकल कोच। टू अंडरस्टैंड द क्लासिफिकेशन ऑफ दी फ्रैक्चर्स वी शुड नो अबाउट द ग्रॉस एनाटोमी ऑफ दी बोन। द लॉन्ग बोन इज डिवाइडेड इन टू एपिफाइसिस, फाइसिस, मेटाफाइसिस एंड डाइफाइसिस रीजन। द फाइसिस इज नोन एज ग्रोथ प्लेट और एपिफाइसियल ग्रोथ प्लेट्स। द एपिफाइसिस इज फर्दर डिवाइडेड इन टू प्रॉक्सिमल एपिफाइसिस एंड डिस्टल एपिफाइसिस। वाइल द फाइसिस इज डो अगेन डिवाइडेड इन टू प्रॉक्सिमल फाइसिस, डिस्टल फाइसिस। मेटाफाइसिस इज सेम डिवाइडेड इन टू प्रॉक्सिमल मेटाफाइसिस एंड डिस्टल मेटाफाइसिस। वाइल द डायफाइसिस इज डिवाइडेड इन टू थ्री सेगमेंट्स, प्रॉक्सिमल, मिडल एंड डिस्टल। प्रॉक्सिमल इज द 1/3 पोर्शन ऑफ द टोटल लेंथ ऑफ द डायफाइसिस। मिडल दिस इज द मिडल सेगमेंट, मिडल 1/3 सेगमेंट एंड डिस्टल इज द डिस्टल 1/3 सेगमेंट ऑफ द डायफाइसिस। इन दिस पिक्चर्स दिस इज द प्रॉक्सिमल एपिफाइसिस, प्रॉक्सिमल मेटाफाइसिस, दिस इज द डायफाइसिस, दिस इज द डिस्टल मेटाफाइसिस, डिस्टल एपिफाइसिस एंड दिस वन इज द फाइसिस। दिस एंड इज नोन एज आर्टिकुलर एंड आर्टिकुलर कैटलिसिस। दिस आर द आर्टिकुलर कैटलिसिस, दिस आर द कॉन्डाइल्स। पेरिओस्टियम ऑस्टियोजेनिक लेयर मोर रेडिली इलेवेटेड फ्रॉम द डायफाइसिस एंड मेटाफाइसिस, ऑफन इंटैक्ट ऑन द कॉनकेव साइड ऑफ द इंजरी, ऑफन हेल्पफुल एज ए हिंज फॉर रिडक्शन, प्रमोट रैपिड हीलिंग। पेरिओस्टियल न्यूबोर्न कंट्रीब्यूट्स टू रिमॉडलिंग। Now we discuss about cardinal signs. Pain. Pain may be there on the palpations or without palpations. Actually, bone does not have any type of the nociceptors. But the periosteum, muscles, blood vessels, nerves surrounding to the fractures have the nociceptors and there is pain. Animal feel the pain through the nociceptors of these adjoining structures. There is deformity in the shape of the overridings, or there may be destruction. Crepitus or grating sound is produced while rubbing the bone ends together. Abnormal mobility at the fracture sites in the abnormal directions. Swelling or edema is there because there is bleeding due to rupture of the blood vessels and this blood is accumulated in the adjoining area that cause the swellings and edema of the particular area. Loss of function, inability to wear the weight, particularly in case of the complete long bone fractures. Now we discuss about diagnosis. Diagnosis of the fracture is performed by detailed clinical examination based on the sign and symptoms, history of the trauma in the recent past, radiographic examination, nuclear bone scan, that is the scintigraphy, ultrasonographic examination, बाय दी सीटी स्कैन, बाय दी MRI, रेडियोग्राफिक इवेल्युएशन, एटलीस्ट टू ऑर्थोगोनल व्यूज मस्ट बी टेकन, द रेडियोग्राफ शुड बी इंक्लूड वन जॉइंट अबव एंड वन जॉइंट बिलो द फ्रैक्चर, अंडरस्टैंड द नॉर्मल ओसिफिकेशन पैटर्न, कंपेरिजन रेडियोग्राफ्स रियली नीडेड बट कैन बी यूजफुल इन सम सिचुएशंस एंड ऑल्सो फॉर द रिसर्च पर्पजेस। क्लासिफिकेशन ऑफ फ्रैक्चर, इट इज इसेंशियल टू क्लासीफाई द फ्रैक्चर टू हेल्प डिटरमाइन द टाइप ऑफ द ट्रीटमेंट और इमोबिलाइजेशन टेक्निक। On the basis, the fractures are classified on the three bases. The first base of the classification of the fracture is communication of the fracture site to the environment. Second base of the fracture classification is extent of fracture line. Third base of the classification of the fracture is anatomical location in relation to the particular bone. These are the three bases of the fracture classification. We will discuss one by one. Now the first, based on the communication of the fracture site to the environment. On this basis, the fracture is classified into two category or two types. First is the closed fracture, that is also known as simple fracture. Second one is the open or compound fracture. So we discuss about the closed fracture or the simple fracture. In this, the skin is intact, there is no wound, no communication with the environment. There is no chance of the contamination, but this is not necessarily this type of the fracture simple to treat. Second one is the open fractures. It is also known as compound fractures. In this, the wound extend through the skin to the bone injury. These type of the fractures are more prone to infections. In this picture, this is the compound fractures, in which this is the wound surface and this is the wound, this is the bone, this is the bone, and this is the open wound. This type of the fractures are more prone for infections. The open fractures or the compound fractures are further classified into three category: first degree, second degree and third degree compound fractures. In the first degree, there is penetration from the inside by the fractured bone. The second degree compound fractures, in which a contused wound inflicted from the outside. While the third degree compound fracture, there is extensive skin, muscle, nerve damage are there. The wound occurs from the outside. Now we discuss about the second basis of the classification, that is extent of the fracture line. On the basis of extent of the fracture line, fractures are classified into two category. A is incomplete fracture, B is complete fracture. First we discuss about the incomplete fracture. In the incomplete fracture, bone has not completely lost its continuity. In this, there are gainstex fracture, fissure fracture or depression fractures. We will discuss these fractures one by one. So A is green stick fractures. One side of the bone is broken and the other side is bent. One side of the bone is broken, other side of the bone is bent. Periosteal and cortical bone discontinuity at the convex side. This is the convex side. This is the convex side. This one is concave side. Often seen in the young animals due to the supple elastic nature of the bone. B. Fissure fracture. Diatoma insufficient to cause the complete fracture. In that conditions, there is cracks or the fissure line appears. Periosteum is intact. Fissures or the crack extending through the bone without displacement of the fragments. The fissure may be longitudinal, may be transverse, may be oblique. This is the fissure line without the displacement of the fragments. In the radiograph, this is the fissure line. This is the CT scan view in which the fractures are not displaced, but this is the fissure line. The segments are not displaced. C is depression fractures, a fractures of the skull bone in which the fragments is depressed below the surface. This type of the depression fractures are commonly seen in the maxilla and frontal bone of the skull. This is the 3D reconstruction image of the skull in which there is the depression fracture. This is the depression fracture. Now we discuss about the complete fracture. Complete loss of continuity with division into two or more fragments. Under this, there may be the transverse fracture, longitudinal fracture, oblique fracture, spiral fracture, comminuted fracture, multiple fracture, impacted fracture, compression fracture, segmental fracture, avulsion fracture, dentate fractures. We will discuss one by one. So first, A is transverse fracture. As name indicated, the fracture line runs transverse to the long axis of the bone. The transverse fractures are caused by bending forces. This is the long axis of the bone and this is the transverse fracture line. So this is the transverse fractures seen also in the radiograph. This is the transverse fracture. Longitudinal fractures. As name indicated, the fracture line runs longitudinal directions. Split pattern like this. And this is the fracture line. This one. Oblique fracture. As name indicated, the fracture line runs oblique to the long axis of the bone. Caused by bending forces with axial compressions. This is the oblique line, this one. A spiral fracture. Fracture line spirals along the long axis of bone caused by torsional or twisting forces like this. In that conditions, there is like this spiral fractures. This is the spiral fractures. This one, this is the fracture line in the spiral fracture. Comminuted fractures. Two or more fracture lines interconnect each other at one point. Interconnect at one point. Fracture line runs in any directions. Three or more fracture fragments are there, caused by high energy trauma. Like this, this fracture line meet at one point. So this is comminuted fractures. In the radiograph, one fracture line, other fracture line, this is also, these are meet on this point. So this is the comminuted fracture. Now we discuss about the multiple fractures. When two or more fracture lines are there which do not interconnect each other but divide the bone into three or more fracture segments is known as multiple fractures. These are the multiple fractures. Same is depicted or in the radiograph. Impacted fractures. One fragment is firmly goes into another. The compression forces under the compression forces, the one segments of the bone is goes into another. Is the one segment of the bone that goes inside of the other bone, like this. Like this. That comes under the another bone after the fracture. This is the impacted fracture. Compression fractures, reduction in length of bone. This type of the fractures are generally occurs in the cancellous bone, particularly in the vertebrae. The length of the bone is decreased. Segmental fractures. Bone is broken into two places in a way that leave at least one segment floating and unattached. This is the first segment. This is the segmental fractures segment. This is the first, second, and third. Second segment is floating and unattached. Same is in the radiograph. First segment, second segment, and third segment. So second segment is floating and unattached with the bone. So this is the segmental fracture. Now we discuss about the avulsion fractures. Fractures of bony prominence by forcible pull to its attachment. Fracture at the attachment of the tendon or ligament, like this. This is pulled by the muscles. This is the olecranoposis. This is pulled upwards, and this fracture is known as avulsion fracture. Dentate fractures. Fracture in which the opening opposing surface are rough with toothed or serrated projections fitting into corresponding indentations, like this. These are fitted fractures and are toothed and interlocked. Third classification, based on the anatomical location in relation to a particular bone. under this there may be diaphyseal fractures. This is the diaphysis. This region is metaphysis. One is metaphysis. This one is epiphysis. Diaphyseal, when there is fracture in the diaphyseal regions. Epiphysis, when there is fracture in the epiphysis regions. Metaphysis, metaphyseal fractures, the fracture of the metaphyseal region. Condylar fractures, when there is fracture of the condyle. Supracondylar fractures, when there is fractures of the fractures in which the both the condyles are separated as a single unit. Intercondylar fractures, when there is fractures between the two condyles, is known as intercondylar or transcondylar fractures. Articular or intra-articular fractures, when there is the fractures on the articular surface or joints are involved, that is known as articular fractures. When there is fractures on the periarticular area but in the joint capsule, is known as periarticular fracture. Transcervical fractures, this is the fractures of the neck of the femur. Transfracture dislocation, when there is fracture of one bone that caused the dislocation of the joints, is known as fracture dislocation. This is when there is fracture of the olecranon process, and simultaneously there is dislocation of the elbow joints, that is known as fracture dislocation. This particular type of the fracture is named as Monteggia fracture. We will discuss later on about the Monteggia fracture. Now the spatial fractures. These are based on the name of the scientist or other spatial features. Under this, first is the Colles fractures. Colles fractures are the fractures of the distal radial metaphyseal region. This is the extra articular fractures. In this, abduction of the paw is seen. Like this, this is the Colles fractures in which paw is abducted. Monteggia fractures. Fractures of olecranon process. This is the olecranon process. And this dislocation of the elbow. This is the elbow that is dislocated. In this, this is the olecranon process. This is the elbow joint. This is dislocated. This is known as Monteggia fracture. Complicated fracture. Fracture in which there is considerable injury to important neighboring vessels or nerve, or accompanied by opening of the joint or visceral cavity. For example, complicated fracture of the rib. Now we discuss about the deferred fractures. Incomplete fracture in which separation of the fragments occurs only after a varying period after the incident due to the subsequent violence, strain or concussion. This type of the deferred fractures are seen as broken back in the process. Now we discuss about the hairline fractures. These fractures are also known as stress fractures. Small crack or severe bruises within a bone are seen. This type of the fractures are generally seen in ortho osteoporosis conditions during the after the running or jumping, there may be hair lines. A small cracks may be seen in the bone. These are known as hairline fractures or stress fracture. Now we discuss about the displaced and non-displaced fractures. Displaced fracture in which the bone breaks into pieces that move out of their normal alignment. While the non-displaced fractures are the fractures in which bone break into pieces that stay in their normal alignment. Now we discuss about the stable and unstable fractures. The stability is on the reductions of the fractures. Stable fractures, the fracture fragments have good contact and can be stabilized with external manipulations. The stable fractures are transverse fracture, green stick fracture, and impacted fractures. Unstable fractures. Fracture fragments have very limited apposition and need to convert to stable fracture to promote healing. The stable fractures, unstable fractures are oblique fracture, comminuted fractures, multiple fractures. Now we discuss about the Salter-Harris classifications. This classification is especially for the facial fractures. Under this, the facial fractures are classified into five categories: type first, type second, type three, type four, type five. In the type first Salter-Harris classification, there is separation through the physis, usually through the area of the hypertrophic and degenerating cartilage cells column. Type second Salter-Harris classification, in which there is fracture through the portion of the physis that extend into the metaphysis. This one. Type three fracture through the portion of the physis that extend through the epiphysis and joints. This is the physis, this is the epiphysis that extend into the joint. Type 4 Salter-Harris classification, in which there is fracture across the metaphysis, physis, and epiphysis. Type 5, there is crush injury of the physis, like this. For easy remember the type of these fractures, as name indicated, as SAL, SALTER. If type first, in which there is straight across, means there is separation of the physis. In type second, above, there is separation of the physis along with fracture of the meta physis. Now L means lower or below. In the type third classification, there is separation of the physis along with fracture of the epiphysis. Now T. In the type 4 Salter-Harris type fractures, in which there is separation of the physis along with fracture of the metaphysis and epiphysis. In the type 5 Salter-Harris classification, there is erasure of growth plates or crush injury. So for the easy remember, always remember SALTER. फ्रेंड्स, हाउ टू राइट द करेक्ट डायग्नोसिस ऑफ द फ्रैक्चर इज वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. आई रोट वन फ्रैक्चर्स सो डेट यू कैन इजिली अंडरस्टैंड हाउ टू राइट द करेक्ट डायग्नोसिस ऑफ द फ्रैक्चर्स इन द रूटीन एज वेल एज हेल्पफुल इन द विटोलिगल एस्पेक्ट्स. नाउ द फर्स्ट वर्ड इज द सिंपल. दिस इज फ्रॉम द टाइप फर्स्ट बेस ऑफ द क्लासिफिकेशन बेस ऑन द कम्युनिकेशन विद द एनवायरमेंट. सेकेंड इज ऑब्लिक दैट कम्स फ्रॉम द टाइप सेकेंड क्लासिफिकेशन दैट इज एक्सटेंट ऑफ द फ्रैक्चर लाइन. थर्ड वर्ड इज कम्स फ्रॉम द थर्ड क्लासिफिकेशन बेस्ड ऑन द एनाटोमिकल लोकेशन इन ए बोन. एंड आफ्टर दैट वी राइट अबाउट द बोन अलोंग विथ देयर साइड एंड इन लास्ट वी राइट अबाउट द एनिमल स्पीसीज This is the standard way to write the diagnosis of the fracture where under the field conditions and where the X-ray facility or other diagnostic facility is not available or we are unable to take the proper radiographs. In that case, we can judge the first simple or compound location on the bone, bifacial, metafacial fractures, but we are unable to diagnose the oblique, transverse, spiral, and other type of the fractures. So, to write this type of the fractures, we omit or we should not write the this type in the writing of in the diagnosis, because without X-ray this is not possible. For examples, suppose one buffalo suffering from the right metacarpal fractures at the diaphyseal region, that is that have the wound, that means open. Then how you write this? Because X-ray facility is not available, or we so under this we can write the fracture as compound 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 diaphyseal fracture of right metacarpal of buffalo. If you have the X-ray facility, then we can add the additional about the oblique, about the transverse, about the spiral, whatsoever, as per the extent of the fracture lines. So this is the right way to write the fracture. Friends, based on today's lecture, we designed some questions for you. You are requested to solve these questions and write the answer on the paper. At the end of this video, we also provide the answers so that you can check yourself. So, ready for the quiz? क्वेश्चन नंबर वन, विच ऑफ दी फॉलोइंग फैक्टर अकर्स एट ए रिजल्ट ऑफ एन इंट्रेंसिक कोच। ऑप्शन ए ग्रीन स्टिक फ्रैक्चर, ऑप्शन बी फिशर फ्रैक्चर, ऑप्शन सी एवल्जन फ्रैक्चर, ऑप्शन डी ऑल अबव। क्वेश्चन टू, इन विच फ्रैक्चर टू और मोर फ्रैक्चर लाइन्स इंटरकनेक्ट ईच अदर एट वन पॉइंट। ऑप्शन ए कंप्रेशन फ्रैक्चर, ऑप्शन बी मल्टीपल फ्रैक्चर, ऑप्शन सी कम्यूनेटेड फ्रैक्चर, ऑप्शन डी इंपैक्टेड फ्रैक्चर। क्वेश्चन थ्री, टाइप ऑफ फ्रैक्चर व्हेन ए सिंगल बोन इज ब्रोकन एट मोर देन टू प्लेस। ऑप्शन ए ट्रांसवर्स फ्रैक्चर, ऑप्शन बी मल्टीपल फ्रैक्चर, ऑप्शन सी एवल्जन फ्रैक्चर, ऑप्शन डी स्पाइरल फ्रैक्चर। क्वेश्चन नंबर फोर, फॉलोइंग विच इज नॉट द एग्जाम्पल ऑफ इनकम्प्लीट फ्रैक्चर। ग्रीन स्टिक फ्रैक्चर, फिशर फ्रैक्चर, इम्पैक्टेड फ्रैक्चर, डिप्रेशन फ्रैक्चर। नाउ क्वेश्चन फाइव, विच टाइप ऑफ बोन फ्रैक्चर इज कॉज्ड बाई ए डिजीज दैट कॉज द बोन टू वीकन। ऑप्शन ए कंपाउंड फ्रैक्चर, ऑप्शन बी कोलेस फ्रैक्चर, ऑप्शन सी पैथोलॉजिकल फ्रैक्चर, ऑप्शन डी ग्रीन स्टिक फ्रैक्चर। नाउ दिस इज द आंसर टाइम, दीज आर द आंसर। क्वेश्चन वन, क्वेश्चन टू, ऑप्शन सी, क्वेश्चन थ्री, ऑप्शन बी, क्वेश्चन फोर, ऑप्शन सी, क्वेश्चन फाइव, ऑप्शन सी। थैंक यू फॉर वॉचिंग दिस वीडियो। यू आर रिक्वेस्टेड टू लाइक, कमेंट्स, शेयर एंड सब्सक्राइब माई यूट्यूब चैनल फ्यूचर वेट्स। इफ यू हैव एनी डाउट्स प्लीज राइट इन कमेंट्स बॉक्स, आई विल रिप्लाई। थैंक्स अगेन फॉर वॉचिंग दिस वीडियो।